emergency has been declared for this area. For emergency details, please tune to channel 2.
Dancing with the Stars or American Idol?
American Idol.
American Idol it is. Our candidates continue their...
The proceeding was brought to you as a community service of this cable company.
Of the New Hampshire Republican presidential debate is sponsored by Cisco, a primary provider of the network technology for CNN's news coverage. Go to cnnpolitics.com to learn more about the issues and candidates in this debate.
This past year alone, there's been a 67% spike in companies embracing the cloud. Big clouds, small ones, public, private, even hybrid. Your data and apps must move easily and securely to reach many clouds, not just one. That's why the network that connects, protects, and lets your data move fearlessly through the clouds means more than ever. Cloud with confidence. See how at cisco.com. Cisco.
The inspiration for its shape was an archer drawing his bow. Could that have also inspired its 556 horsepower supercharged engine? The all-new Cadillac CTS-V Coupe. We don't just make luxury cars, we make Cadillacs.
A lot of times things are right underneath our feet and all we need to do is change the way we're thinking about them. A couple decades ago, we didn't even realize just how much natural gas was trapped in rocks thousands of feet below us. Technologies made it possible to safely unlock this clean and burning natural gas. These deposits can provide us with fuel for 100 years, providing energy security and economic growth all across this country. It just takes somebody having the idea, and that's where the discovery comes from.
Welcome back to our Republican debate here in the first in the nation primary state of New Hampshire. Seven candidates up on stage as they try to impress the voters of New Hampshire and the voters of the country tonight. We've become, we are told, a trending topic on Twitter. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to look up there just a bit. We'll get to some of these questions because they're good questions. Privatization there, improving relationships with the Middle East. What industries do you think can reinvent America? All good suggestions from concerned citizens across the country watching this debate unfold. Before we go and out of every break, we're doing an exercise called This or That to learn more about our candidates. The speaker had no hesitation at all. American Idol over Dancing with the Stars. Congressman Paul, BlackBerry or iPhone?
BlackBerry.
BlackBerry it is. All right, we're going to continue our conversation now. We want to bring up a very important issue you know all of you will want to weigh in on, and that is the debate about entitlements. Mr. Cain mentioned those, and specifically Medicare. Right now, I want to go down to our audience. We've got Josh McKelvin with a question.
Thanks very much, John. And I have Dr. Paul Collins, who you've been running a family practice in Manchester for how long?
27 years.
Nice work. So not surprising your question is related to health care. What's your question, sir?
Yes, sir. As a member of the baby boomer generation, I've been contributing to Medicare through payroll taxes for over 30 years. How do you propose to keep Medicare financially solvent for the next 50 years and beyond?
Let's start with Dr. Paul on this one.
Well, under today's conditions, it's not solvent and won't be solvent. You know, if you're an average couple and you paid your entire amount into Medicare, you would have put $140,000 into it. And in your lifetime, you will take out more than three times that much. So a little bit of arithmetic tells you it's not solvent. So we're up against the wall on that. So it can't be made solvent. It has to change. We have to have more competition in medicine. And I would think that if we don't want to cut any of the medical benefits for children or the elderly, because we have drawn so many in and got them so dependent on the government, if you want to work a transition, you have to cut a lot of money. And that's why I argue the case that this money ought to be cut out of foreign welfare and foreign militarism and corporate welfare and the military-industrial complex. Then we might have enough money to tie people over. But some revamping has to occur. What we need is competition. We need to get a chance for the people to opt out of the system. Just to talk about opting out of Obamacare, why can't we opt out of the whole system and take care of ourselves?
All right, let's continue the conversation. Governor Pawlenty.
Congressman Paul says opt out. Congressman Ryan says squeeze a lot of savings across the federal budget, including a lot out of Medicare, to turn it into an, he doesn't like this word, but turn it essentially into a voucher program. Instead of having the federal program, the government would give you some money and you'd go out in the marketplace and shop for it. Is that the right way to do it?
Let me first address the doctor. Doctor, you said in your question that you've paid in your whole life, and we respect that. People have made plans, particularly people who are on the program now or close to eligibility. We should keep our word to people that we've made promises to. So under my proposal, if you're on the program or near the program, we'll keep our word. But we also have to recognize what Congressman Paul just said. There was a recent report out that the premiums for Medicare and the payroll withholdings are only paying about half the program. So it is not financially solvent. We have to fix it. We have to reform it. I'm going to have my own plan, John, that will feature some differences from Congressman Ryan's plan. It'll feature performance pay rather than just volume pay to hospitals and clinics and providers. It will allow Medicare to continue as an option, but it'll be priced against various other options that we're going to offer people as well, and some other things. And I also said, if it was a choice between Barack Obama's plan of doing nothing, we have a president of the United States got one of the worst crises financially in the history of the country, and you can't find him on these issues. He's missing. I'll lead on this issue.
All right, Governor. Mr. Speaker, I want to bring you into this conversation because I'm looking down. I want to get the words just right. Your initial reaction to the Ryan plan, it's a radical right-wing social engineering. Then you backtrack. Why?
Well, first of all, there was a very narrow question which said, should Republicans impose an unpopular bill on the American people? Now, I supported the Ryan budget as a general proposal. I actually wrote a newsletter supporting the Ryan budget. And those words were taken totally out of context. I'm happy to repeat them. If you're dealing with something as big as Medicare and you can't have a conversation with the country where the country thinks what you're doing is the right thing, you better slow down. Remember, we all got mad at Obama because he ran over us when we said don't do it. Well, the Republicans ought to follow the same ground rule. If you can't convince the American people it's a good idea, maybe it's not a good idea. So let me start over there. Second, there are certain things I would do different than Paul Ryan on Medicare. I agree strongly with him on Medicaid. I think it could be done. But let me just say two quick things.
Quickly.
Congressman Tom Price has a very good bill in that would allow private contracting so those people who want to voluntarily could contract with their doctor or their hospital in addition to Medicare, and it would be outside the current system, and it would relieve the pricing pressure in the current system. We did a study called Stop Paying the Crooks. We think you can save $70 to $120 billion. In Medicare and Medicaid annually by not paying crooks.
All right, we have to save time. Let me start with the senator first. Should the Republicans slow down?
No. We have a $1.4 trillion deficit, and it isn't getting any better anytime soon. We have to deal with this problem now. And what Paul Ryan has suggested, which I wholeheartedly support, is to use a program that is identical to what seniors already have. It's called Medicare Part D. They have a program right now, which seniors like. It is a program that's called a premium support program. We give seniors, depending on income, a certain amount of money so they can go out and they can purchase health care that they want that helps them. And this is the key, John. We need to include seniors in controlling costs. What President Obama, let me finish, please. What President Obama has done is he put in the Obamacare bill, the Independent Payment Advisory Board. Ladies and gentlemen, seniors, Medicare is going to be cut starting in 2014 by the federal government, and it's going to be rationing of care from the top down. What Paul Ryan and Rick Santorum want to do, which is not radical, which is take a program, Medicare prescription drugs, that is 41% under budget because seniors are involved in controlling costs, and apply it all to Medicare. It is the right approach for Medicare.
The speaker's point, Mr. Cain, was that if you've lost the American people, if they're not following you, you have to slow down until you can get them with you. Is that a fair point?
We don't need to slow down. I hate to tell you, I hate to be the one to give you the bad news, doctor. You're not going to get most of the money you put into Medicare if we don't restructure it. The reason we are in the situation we are today with Medicare and Social Security is because the problem hadn't been solved. We can no longer rearrange it. We've got to restructure those programs. Okay. And the Paul Ryan approach, I totally support. And he has been very courageous in taking the lead on this. And you know that commercial where they have demagogued the whole thing with Medicare and having grandma tossed off the bridge? If we don't fix this problem, it's going to be our grandkids in that wheelchair that they're going to be throwing off the bridge. We have got to fix the problem.
Let's continue the conversation on entitlements. I know Mr. Congressman Bachmann wants to get in. Others want to get in.